Hey guys, it's Helena. So as we know, climate change is a universal issue. However, it disproportionately impacts the lives of Black people and people of color. So today I wanted to look at how and why racism plays a role in climate change. Although there are multiple layers to the issues of environmental justice and environmental racism, today I just wanted to touch upon two issues, which are pollution exposure and unequal protection that Black people and people of color face when it comes to climate change. If we look at some facts, African Americans are 38% more likely to be exposed to air pollution compared to white Americans. So if we look at pollution exposure, according to the NAACP, Black and Latinx communities are more likely to live near toxic facilities. And toxic facilities are basically coal power plants, waste incineration plants, and other oil and gas facilities, which can emit lead, mercury, and other harmful toxins into the water, food, and lungs of these communities. Another issue is that these facilities release greenhouse gases such as methane and carbon dioxide, which we know are actually really troublesome greenhouse gases. African Americans make up about 13% of the US population. However, 68% of African Americans live within 30 miles of coal power plants, as opposed to 56% of whites. In a National Geographic article on toxic waste, it states that a disproportionate number of toxic waste sites tend to be located in or near low-income and communities of color, in part because such communities often have fewer resources to oppose such activities. Living in these areas contribute to a range of health issues like asthma, heart attacks, and birth defects. Just by looking at who is exposed to these toxins and who is living closest to these toxic facilities, we can see that environmental racism and racism plays a role in climate change. Another issue that arises when looking at race and climate change is the unequal protection of certain communities when it comes to climate change. So Black and communities of color often receive less attention, help, and protection when faced with climate challenges. So as climate change brings about more severe storms and weather patterns, people that are living in at-risk areas are the ones who are facing the immediate impacts of rising sea levels, flooding, and basically they may need to relocate as a result. For example, if we look at Hurricane Katrina, the government put their funding into Lakeview, which was a predominantly white neighborhood, so that they could reinforce their levees and help protect them from future flooding. However, Black communities did not receive the same amount of funding or protection for rebuilding their levees in case there was another storm. So when Katrina hit, Black communities were not able to protect themselves because these levees were not strong enough to support the storm. What's even more shocking is that African Americans, although they were hit the hardest by the storm, when it came to government relief and rebuilding of this area, white communities and neighborhoods received the most immediate amount of help and funding to rebuild those areas. Versus Black communities, although they faced the most amount of flooding, they were not put as a priority for rebuilding and reconstruction. Another example of unequal protection is looking at the instance which took place in Porter Ranch, LA, which was a predominantly white neighborhood. There was a really horrible methane gas leak from a nearby facility, and obviously the citizens complained and voiced their concerns about feeling dizzy, experiencing rashes and vomiting, and that particular gas company ended up helping to relocate those citizens because of the leak. However, if we look at Jefferson Park, which is a predominantly Black and Latinx community, they also complained about oil and gas facilities and drilling in their neighborhood. So the residents there were also facing vomiting and other respiratory illnesses as a result of living so close to these facilities. However, it took significantly longer for that drilling site to close down as a result of their complaints, and it really only happened once moderators went to look at that area and felt sick themselves. As you can see, even when it comes to the same issues, the response that predominantly white communities receive versus predominantly Black communities receive when it comes to climate change, predominantly white communities often receive the more immediate and better assistance as opposed to Black communities. In regards to climate change, we can see how racial inequality plays a big role as well. These past few weeks have definitely been a wake-up call for all of us to look at how systemic racism still exists in our society and what we can do to be actively anti-racist and support the Black Lives Matter movement. Educating ourselves and listening to Black voices are key. So below, I'll put some resources if you want to read more about racism and climate change and how you can take action to support the Black Lives Matter movement. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.